Hello, this is Arpit from MTechBurn. I am going to present the topic, the difference between the Dalvik virtual machine versus the Java virtual machine. So I will go through the presentation in the following order. First one, I will cover the introduction about the virtual machine, then the Dalvik virtual machine, Java virtual machine, examples and the comparison between these two, and I will explain the difference between these two with the help of experimental evaluation. Now the first topic is the virtual machine. So where does the need of virtual machine came into play? So in earlier days, what we used to do is write the program in the same, we compile the program, write the program and run the program in the same platform in which we are using. But to eliminate this one, what we are having is virtual machine so that we can distribute the program in an architectural neutral format. That means we can write a program in some other platform and run that program in some other platform. Now, as you all are working with the Android OS, so you know very well about that, but I would like to explain further. Android OS is a kind of software stack which is consists of Java application which is running on Java framework. But the difference is that it is using Dalvik virtual machine which other Java based operating system is not using. And that Dalvik virtual machine is using Dalvik executable code, which other Java based operating system are using that JVM. Like I will explain in this diagram. Okay, I will explain. Means this is a complete framework of Android, and here we are having Android runtime which is using code libraries which are of Java and the Dalvik virtual machine. So here comes the difference. Earlier we used to have JVM, Java virtual machine, running over there, which is at the bottom of Java code libraries. Now what is DVM? So it is a virtual machine which is used by Google, and it is run on Android devices. So the Dalvik virtual machine is same as that of Java virtual machine, but the difference lies in the fact that it is using .deck file as its executable, while the JVM is using Java bytecodes. So first of all, what we do is we first compile our Java program so that we get a dot class file, and using a tool named DX, we convert that class file into .deck file which is used as an executable so that we can run an application. Now why we are using Dalvik virtual machine? What is the means advantages of Dalvik virtual machine? First one is that it provides application portability, which is also provided by the JVM. And second one is it is using file format .deck, which is much simplified as compared to our Java bytecode, which is used by JVM. So here comes the difference. And the third one is minimal memory footprint. As it is using less memory, I will explain it further why it is using less memory. So this advantage comes. Now the .deck format, what exactly is .deck format? What we are having is we are having a tool, a DX, which converts the class file into .deck file. And here what happened with the Java bytecode is, when we are having a Java code, when it gets compiled, then for all of the classes a separate class file is created. But this is not happening in the case of .deck file. When we compile a Java code, then many class file, multiple class file can be merged and they can be put in a .deck format, .deck file. Okay. So size, if we compare it as size wise, then it is quite less as compared to the Java bytecode. So that's why it is using less memory. It is same as this one. So once we are having our .deck file, so we can use it for Dalvik virtual machine, as it knows only .deck file. And here's the difference. Means a class file contains only one class, a .deck file contains multiple classes. Now zygote. So what's the problem in this is, in Android OS, each application has its own instance of VM. Means it is using each application is using different instance of VM. So we have to manage the different instance of VM. So for that purpose, Android is using a concept called zygote, so that they can share the code between different VM instances, as well as for the fast startup of different VM instances, we need this one, zygote. So basically this is used to make switch between the different VMs and to make the startup fast. Now the Java virtual machine, as you all know that this virtual machine is can execute the Java bytecode, and this is having a standard class library that is having, that implements the basic Java APIs, sorry. And it is always marketed as write once, run anywhere. As you all know, it is platform independent language. In this one, in JVM, the source code is compiled into Java bytecode, which is stored as a class file, and it can be used further over different platforms. And yeah, here is an example that if we are in a Java code, if we are having five classes, then once it gets compiled, then we are getting five dot class file as output. So means the overall summary is that we are getting a different class file for each of the classes. So here is the comparison between these two virtual machines. The first one is the register based, other one is the stack based. I will come later what is meant by register and stack based. But for that time you better know that it is register based, means it's faster. Okay. And it executes .dat file while it executes .class file. And the third one is important, that it is using this constant pool, and where it stores all the fields and methods of that class file, of various class file, and when it is referred, they are referred with the help of an index. While in the JVM, we are maintaining a different class, we are maintaining a heterogeneous constant pool for each of the classes. Means for different classes, we are having a different field methods similar. Like this one, here is a .jar package which is having like different classes. So for each classes, we are maintaining a class field method attributes and heterogeneous constant pool for each of the classes. While for .apk, which is a similar container for .dec file, it is having the means it is not storing these things means. For each of the classes, it is storing once and they are referred as with the help of an index later on. Now there are disadvantages as usual of deck file. So what is the disadvantage is since we are using this constant pool over and over again, so we have to maintain logical pointers. So here is an overhead of maintaining that pointers. And the second one is JVM is simple to write, means it backend wise, if we see the code wise, then it's quite simpler than as compared to DVM, Dalvik Virtual Machine. Now I will explain the difference between the stack versus register with the help of on the basis of cost. And the cost of executing a VM instruction depends on mainly three things. First one is dispatching the next VM instruction, then accessing the operands and perform the computation. Now dispatching the instruction involves means fetching the next VM instruction and then jumps to the corresponding segment. So suppose if we have an example A equal to B plus C, so for stack based JVM, what we have the instruction is like I load C, I load B, add and then store. But for virtual machine, it is like I add ABC. So as compared to this, the number of instructions are quite less in register based, while the size of an instruction is more as compared to a that stack based. So that's a kind of trade off between the size of the instruction and the number of instruction between these two. Now operand accessing, that in stack based, the operands are found relative to the stack pointer, means with the help of a stack pointer we can access them. But in register base, we have to make them access appears through explicitly. That means we have to make them explicit. We have to refer them explicit. So like so because of this, the size of instruction becomes larger, while the number of instruction becomes less. So since the size is increasing, that is the reason why stack architecture is more popular that time. But later on we find out that the increase in size is as compared to the number of instruction decrease won't affect, means like that the overall I will explain through graph. I think it's better. In stack based JVM, the local variable is accessed using an index, while the operand stack is accessed using an stack pointer. While in case of register based JVM, there is no concept of stack. So everything is accessed with the help of registers only. Like this one, here we have this is stack based JVM. We have local variables, frame data and operand stack, and it is accessed with the help of index and it is accessed with the help of stack pointers. While this one in virtual register, That means Dalvik virtual machine kind of. We access both local variables and operand stack with the help of index only. Now, if we want to translate from stack to register, then we need to translate all the implicit operands to the explicit operands. So what we do is, if this is our stack based byte code, which is having iload, iload, iadd and istore. So for register based, what we do is, for load, we move from R1 to R10, register 1 to register 10, then for this R2 to R11, and then add and then store. We are putting the variables from local variable to the operand stack. While in store, we are putting back from the operand stack to the local variable. That I think you should all know what exactly that means. Okay. Now, since here we are having move instruction, so it is getting redundant. For load also we are having move instruction, for store also we are having move instruction. So to remove that redundancy, we have copy propagation. So we are having forward copy propagation and backward copy propagation. So if we are having these type of instruction, which we got after translating it into register based JVM. So for instead of moving the R1 to R10 and R2 to R11, when we do forward copy propagation, so we can write R10 and R11 R1 and R2, means with the help of forward copy propagation, we replace these two by these two. Okay. And with the help of backward copy propagation, since we are moving the value of R10 to R3, so instead of here R10, we will write R3. So these four instructions are merged and combined to form a single instruction. So that's the power of this experimental evaluation shows that we are having when we use register based architecture, so the overall decrease in the number of instruction is 47%, means we have to execute 47% less instruction as compared to the stack based architecture, but the overall size of each instruction is getting 25% larger for register based architecture. So but when we compare these two, then we find out that executing 47% less instruction is much better than we can accept this 47% with this, means 25%. So using register based is quite better. And in graph also we see that this is blue lines are code size. So when we find out that these all are approximate to 25%.